I just keep doing what's important to me in surfing at the time. The Alea was the ultimate thing because the Alea is the ultimate surfboard. Head straight up, it's the fastest, does the bed cuts back, tube rides the deepest. Totally focused on that, but almost nobody can ride an Alea. So then I made the foam boards to make it easier to get that same sort of feeling. And you almost get the same feeling, but it's a lot easier to ride. And now it's the belly boards. I have actually had a hurt hip, had a hard time standing up in small waves, and the surf's been small. So I get my belly board, and I'm inside those little tubes and enjoying surfing, probably more than I ever have riding a little wood belly board and getting back into it and finding the incredible complexity and technique it takes to ride a little wood belly board. And I gave a speech on it last night into a packed audience. It was amazing. It was a big room. And people were stoked. And the enormous history of the little wood belly board that is supposedly, simple or a lowly thing, but it's not at all. It's a very complex piece of equipment. And I love it. Going back to wood is actually really popular. As a matter of fact, 7 years ago when I started riding Aleas, I was the only person, well, Jacob Stuth and I were the only two people in the world riding Aleas. And you can see now all over the place, there's Polonia wood, there's Aleas. And so, yeah, it worked. That was probably the most successful surfboard movement in modern times, was they had taken the fins off and riding a little flat piece of wood. And then all the spin-offs from that, there is so much change in surfboard design. And you can see it here at the Byron Bay Festival, how much it's changed. And the Alea has made an enormous impact. Nobody talks about it so much, but it's obvious, there it is. Surfboards didn't look like this 7 years ago. Yeah. With the surf art and the surfboard, with the Alea, it's instantaneous, it's very individualistic. Each Alea has to be a custom surfboard for you because they're so hard to ride that you have to have the best board possible or you probably won't be able to do it. And then the second thing is you can shape an Alea, burn your art into it, and take it surfing in about a 4-hour time period. And then right now they're burning up little hand planes, out of the wood. So it's exciting, and you really have a very custom piece that you can make all by yourself and come out with a terrific board in a very short time that's not toxic. So the Byron Bay Festival is kind of really a part of that. It's this now artistic, simple, but complex organism. How's that, Ned?
Tom Wegener, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, you guys. Cheers.